found is that the areas that we where the council, this committee had made decisions were actually not under the control of our contracts with our contractors. They're actually under the Brecon Council contractors. So we'll have to write to Brecon Council and formally ask them to inform their contractors of the decisions of this committee and ask them to take that into account. That letter also hasn't been sent, but at least it's on the action list, so hopefully that will be a prompt.
That's correct. And as we discussed previously, there probably be no financial saving for us from that. But we wanted to give Brecon the presumably Serco enough time that they can change their machinery for next year and build that into the plan. So we should crack on with that. Costing priorities into projects. Again, we've got a budget agenda item today.
Started to look for them. That's as far as I can report. I know Nick reminded me the other day that we have to locate them, so we're on that particular basis.
Okay. So with that one, what we're looking for is clarity on if we have the kit, and if not, we need to order some more, and then also the procedures when we do issue them to people, the do's and the don'ts and picking up. I know every year the keeper in Thailand
spoke to me about it, I was aware of that. Regarding my own bit and doing health and safety, I must admit I've not been as active as I should have been. I've got back in now and I did 10 years last week. I'm off to Brecon next Wednesday for my new health and safety training on Wednesday morning, and then I'm going to hope to get back to doing a more regular update with the health.
So it's not just a bit of hanging baskets side of things.
questions, whether it's highways, Brecon or Thetford Town, where the literally where the statue is. As far as I know, nobody knows who owns that piece of land.
Good question.
Something that's always bothered me, Chair, because I, as Stuart said, I was of the knowledge that it was Thetford land originally, and when it was remodeled,
yeah,
it kind of disappeared. And I think it should be formalised if it's going to be Norfolk County Council land, or ours, or Stanleyford, or whatever.
That's not okay. It will come back to us, because as Nick said,
it will
still be in place.
Finger signs. They
yeah.
Thetford.
Yeah, the finger signs they are currently being looked at as well. The town team, they are gradually going around and obviously securing them. Wash as well.
Yes, so we had an issue with a visitor trying
the
to
black last
night. Facing
yeah.
around here.
Somewhere on the ground. Yeah, there's
Flora Group sent us an update in 2017 regarding the new plants that were coming back onto common, etc., etc. Now we're 4 years on, it might be beneficial to get that report updated. Then we could put that out to the public, show the various plants that are coming back.
Absolutely.
New species of ants that appears have come back and stuff like this. We've kind of done.
Yeah, I think that's something that's been happening in the past, maybe habitat monitoring. Yeah. So the raising, it's a great idea, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, just say what we are doing.
Yeah, I don't think.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah, really, you turn around for this stuff. So I've been told why we're doing it, and I think we're beating them.
Yes,
to be honest with you. So,
very kind, we are getting to the end of our raising season for this.
So I see it as an opportunity, because we're going to expand our grazing to a new area. It's a good opportunity to go back and say, actually, this is why we're doing it, and this is why we're expanding it.
Yeah.
Let's see, technical there.
Cool.
Yeah. Just in the report, when you put hours completed 97.5 for October, if you could put a rough estimate of the sort of financial cost, if that would have been, you know, I can do the maths roughly in my head, it's close to 100, I don't know about that. We actually state in the report what the conservation volunteers are doing is tremendous. You know, they're saving us a significant amount of money and improving the environment. So if we one is the number of hours they're doing, but actually nearly 100 times you go and raise about £10. For October alone, that's a significant contribution.
I'm just sort of really
highlight that.
Yeah.
And then last month we spoke briefly about the Brazier recruitment. Conscious of many committee meetings, members at the meeting last month. When do you anticipate, or how do you anticipate working in terms of the recruitment for the Grazing and how the committee can be involved in that?
Hopefully, get the fence management structure completed first.
Yeah.
And then I believe there's various tenant documents we have available to us, actually, then an issue about.
Thank you, Chair. From an income perspective, you'll know most of our income comes in November, December, which is our HLS grants. So hopefully we should receive those shortly, and that will make the financial position look of the committee look a lot stronger. From an expenditure perspective, we are below budget by about 4,000. Our budget is skewed towards the end of the year, so there's more costs come in at the end of the year. All our costs have been processed, so all the contractor costs are there. They finally decided to send through invoices. We've decided to process them and pay them. The only one that I would like to talk about is there is an invoice for tree works, which we haven't accrued. It only arrived the other day, and we've just done some investigative work. But when we talk about the tree safety, we'll talk about that. But otherwise, you know, I think overall our expenditure is 3,500 below budget. We are forecasting that position should hopefully remain the same. So there should be some budget savings at the end of the year. And that's very typical of what we're finding at most of the other committees, is that because I think of COVID, et cetera, that it is more difficult to spend money. We were talking about a simple order today for some nuts and bolts, and even the supplier didn't have those available. So it just goes to show how difficult it is to spend. But I'm fairly confident that this reflects where we are in terms of our budget. I was supposed to print out a pack to see whether I, in the crisis of pre-meeting we had, I haven't done that, so please be a little bit tolerant of his. £2,300 last year as when we were doing the year end for the committee. So we're hoping that the winter's kind to us and we don't have any emergency works, we should actually have come under budget. And if you remember, the reason we just wanted to put a little bit of emphasis on this, this is one of the risk areas when we were doing this year's budget, we identified trees as, you know, with a little bit of hits and miss. So it is a little bit reassuring that we actually are on track there and that hopefully that budget will remain intact.
Seen the tree server report. Could you send me a copy when you get when it's sorted to safety, yes. One, please?
Could I make a suggestion? Should we send it to all members of the committee?
Yeah,
and that will.
Thank you.
liabilities. I think you'd vote against it rather than for it. Contingency that it will be funded from the COVID-19 will need council approval because of that reserve is a general reserve established by council, so it will be that. So you might want to defer that decision or just make it now so that if we do need it, we can spend it.
After Christmas, right? I'm just, I'm quite like to miss the point. Yeah. The point
put a note on the Friends of King's House Gardens that we hadn't received the signed constitution. The signed constitution was delivered to me yesterday, so I'm now in possession of that. So they meet the overall criteria of the grant. Just on that one, we as the town council actually administer that trust on their behalf. Any expenditure has to go through our normal expenditure processes, so that the kind of assessment has been slightly different, and that we have, you know, I don't think we need to protect ourselves from ourselves. We would be able to exercise any governance over that particular money. It's really just on the objective is in the very, it's this part here. It's really just further developing the gardens.
Yeah, I'm happy with that, but I mean, I would like to see the application.
That was pure oversight by my side, so I do apologise to the committee members. Borough Museum. Again, they sent through quite a comprehensive application. There's one issue that needs to be confirmed. It's really around the check signatories, if I remember correctly. But that's relatively easy to do when we send the application out to them. They also indicated that they'll send us annual accounts. They actually haven't done that. So I will follow that up and, if possible, resubmit this information to the committee at the next meeting in December.
Can I suggest that if members are content that we approve this and we have approved for arts and art, the subject to Alan being content with the accounts, and then if they send it through now tomorrow, we don't have to wait. I don't think we actually have a meeting scheduled for December, we don't get a meeting. Just to say no, so that would mean the next actual meeting is January. And I'm reading the narrative there.
We did send them the grant acceptance letter. They apparently couldn't work out who had submitted the grant application, and they'd asked everyone except for the person whose name was on the application. So we had to go through that process. So they will be sending back their letter, and then we can organise the check presentation. I'll ask through Kerry for you, Mike.
You will send some on my own, I will get a council some recognition.
I'll put an extra star in my notes. Nothing that I just would like to sensitise the committee that there's a lot of correspondence relating to the fish pass where that has been the EA are involved, and what we've tried to do is not as a council kind of respond formally, because there has been threat of legal action and all sorts of things, and if councillors are approached, just to refer them to the town clerk so that we have one avenue of communication, because there is so many emails flying around and comments made, and some of them may or may not be true, and we just don't want to put the council just undertaking their normal responsibilities, possibly under, responding to misinformation.
Yeah.